every second, about 4 people are born. Right now, there are about 8 billion people breathing. On the other end, about 2 people die every second. One day, it will be you. What's the most likely way you will die? Let's look at how people are dying. In 2021, about 70 million people died. The average age of those people was 71.7 years. 16% of these deaths were caused either by COVID-19 directly or indirectly due to the impact of the pandemic on health systems and society. Since these were special circumstances, let's go back to 2019 to get a better picture. The life expectancy now rises to 73.3 years. In 2 years, COVID-19 took away 1.6 years from the global life expectancy. For every 100 deaths, 75% were due to non-communicable diseases. In other words, diseases that are not directly transmissible from one person to the other. 18% of deaths fall into the group of communicable diseases, as well as maternal, neonatal, and nutritional diseases. The World Health Organization puts these causes of death under the same category, and they're more common in lower-income countries. 8% of deaths were due to injuries, either accidental or intentional. Okay, so now we know you will probably die from a non-communicable disease. Is that bad? We all want to live healthy and die of old age, but technically, you don't die of old age. You die from some underlying health problem like cancer or heart disease that makes your body stop functioning. That falls into the category of non-communicable diseases. So having a high percentage of death coming from non-communicable diseases is actually a sign of the good progress we've made in healthcare. If we go back to 1990, the percentage of people dying from non-communicable diseases goes down from 75 to 58%. The estimated life expectancy was just 65.5 years, almost 8 years lower than 2019's. Having said this, there's still a lot of work to be done. Let's drill down this data. In 2019, cardiovascular diseases were responsible for 33% of deaths, followed by cancers with 17%, and a list of other causes. This data is useful, but it doesn't give us the full picture. Most people will agree that the death of an 85-year-old who gets a cardiovascular disease is not as tragic as the death of a 5-year-old child who dies from malnutrition. So, what causes of death should we actually be worried about? There's an answer to that, but doing all this research takes a lot of time, and it was only possible thanks to today's sponsor, Odoo. Odoo is an all-in-one management platform with 12 million users that helps you manage your whole business, and they also allow you to build a website for free. Let's say you want to build a website to promote your portfolio or your side hustle selling candles. All you have to do is to follow 4 small steps, choose your theme, and simply drag and drop elements onto your website. You can add all sorts of stuff to make your website look professional, and you can see how easy it is to customize it. You can easily adjust the layout, adapt the text, change the size of images, add animations, and a lot more. It also has ChatGPT integrated, so you can use it to quickly reword your text. A website is a great way to boost your brand, whether that's a business or a personal portfolio. It's a great way to sell yourself. With Odoo, your first application is free for life. But if your brand grows, then their platform has a lot of business management apps you can expand to. You can click the link in the description to get started for free. You get unlimited hosting and support for life, and you get offered a custom domain name for 1 year. Fortunately, there are people investigating which diseases we should be worrying about. The Burden of Disease study is the result of a data analysis of over 300,000 different sources and measures the global impact of each disease. It's a study made by 12,000 people, including hundreds of researchers from all around the world. I got to interview one. This is Dr. Michael Brower, one of the principal research scientists behind the study.
We're doing this to get useful information and then actually spread it out to people that need it.
It turns out there's a more sophisticated way to measure the burden of a disease than just counting the number of deaths.
It's not a new metric, but one that I guess many people aren't familiar with, which is called this disability adjusted life year, which is a DALY.
A DALY represents the equivalent of 1 year of good health. So let's say you're a healthy 60-year-old with a life expectancy of 85 years. One day you get a disease that lowers your life expectancy to 80 and leaves you at 50% of your full health for the rest of your life. That means you lose 5 years due to an early death, plus the equivalent of 50% of the 20 years you live with disability, which is 10 years, which means the disease has a total burden of 15 dollies. Let's convert the death counts into dollies to see if something changes. These results raise questions. Cardiovascular diseases and cancers are still at the top of the list, representing the highest burden on humanity, but maternal and neonatal disorders now climb to the third place of the list. It makes sense since these problems affect people at an early stage of their lives and can have a health impact that lasts a lifetime. But it also shows there's still a lot of work to be done in developing countries regarding healthcare and nutrition. Other causes of burden raise different questions. For example, cardiovascular diseases can be caused by many factors. They can be linked to genetics, but they can also be linked to other factors, like a poor diet, smoking, or high blood pressure. We don't just want to know how people die, we also want to know why they're dying like this. And the answer to that question surprised me. The study also looks at the risk factors behind diseases. If we rank these factors in terms of their impact measured in dollies, we see that the fifth biggest risk factor is a poor diet, the fourth is tobacco, smoking is pretty bad for you, the third factor is high systolic blood pressure.
People think about, you know, is high blood pressure, is that a disease or is it a risk factor? Well, we can lower high blood pressure with medications as well as through other changes. So it is something we can actually modify.
The second biggest risk factor was a big surprise for me. It's air pollution.
The good news about smoking is that most people in most populations don't smoke. Air pollution, you don't get to choose. Most of the world, you know, 99% of the world, is living in locations that are above levels at which we can measure harmful effects of air pollution.
Air pollution is linked to several diseases and is responsible for millions of deaths per year. And the biggest risk factor is child and maternal malnutrition. The reality is that the vast majority of my audience comes from high-income countries. So there's a high chance you will not relate to this, even though it's still the biggest risk factor globally. It's a reminder that the situation is not the same throughout the world. Child and maternal malnutrition causes a big burden on low-income countries.
Sub-Saharan Africa stands out. Even though there have been huge improvements, it's still the place where infant mortality, maternal mortality, and infant, you know, disease is highest.
But for other risk factors, Africa is not the region that stands out.
Some of the countries in Eastern Europe, to some extent Central Asia as well, where their older populations, susceptible to a lot of things, diets are quite poor, there's still relatively high smoking, levels of air pollution.
If you want to explore the data yourself and see how your country's doing, check out this data visualization tool made by the Institute for Health Metrics and Evaluation. I left a link in the description. So this is our current situation. Where are we heading? The 2021 Global Burden of Disease Study offers a cautiously optimistic outlook for the future. They forecast that life expectancy will continue to rise globally and that the inequality between regions will shrink. However, they also point out a few key risk factors we should address equitably across all regions of the world. Particulate matter pollution, a form of air pollution, high blood sugar, high body mass index, and other risks related to obesity and metabolic syndrome. Today, we are less likely to die early from a disease than our parents. And it seems that the same will be true for the next generation. Thank you for watching. If you like stories told with data, consider subscribing to the channel. If you're already a subscriber, you might have noticed that the channel's logo and animation style have changed a little bit. Let me know what you think. And thank you to our patrons.